Hello, this is Stefan Marek from Conduktor. And in this lecture, I want to show you how to set up Apache Kafka with Docker. And the reason I do so is that because we'll be using Docker later on this course to launch a bigger Kafka setup, because this will make it extremely easy for us to get started with Kafka and to just worry about learning Kafka and not about how to start Kafka. So to do so, we will start to leverage an open source project that Conduktor has created, which is called Conduktor Kafka Stack Docker Compose. And at the time of recording, we have over 1.5 thousand stars on GitHub. So it is a very popular project online, and we're very happy to use this as part of the community and use this in this course. So we are going to have the same setup, which is one Kafka broker and one zookeeper. But this time, both the Kafka broker and the zookeeper instance are going to be launched using Docker. So what is Docker? If you don't know, Docker is a container technology that will allow us to start Kafka very quickly with less setup involved once we have set up Docker, obviously. You don't need to be an expert of Docker for this course. We'll be going through some very basic commands. You just have to follow along with me. So we'll start Kafka using Docker, and for this, we'll obviously install Docker and download it. And we'll need to make sure Docker has enough memory assigned to it so we can start Kafka and Zookeeper. So we'll clone or download the GitHub project to have the files that we need for Docker. And then we will start Kafka and Zookeeper in only one command. The result is going to be the same as before. So if you want to skip this step, you can. But just know that if you skip this step, you're going to have a little bit more trouble following this course once I have multiple brokers and the schema registry and so on. So that's it. Now let's go ahead and set up Kafka with Docker. So for this method, we're going to use Kafka Stack Docker Compose on GitHub, which is an open source repository that we have created with Conduktor. So it has 1.6 thousand stars on GitHub, so it is quite popular, and we try to keep it as updated as possible. So we'll be using this project to start Kafka, and there will be multiple stacks available to us to start Kafka with multiple brokers when we need to. So I'm going to just download the code, and I will download the zip right here, but you can clone this project using GitHub if you know how to do so. Okay. So my code is downloaded, and the prerequisites to running this project is that I have to install Docker. So Docker installation varies based on how you are set up, if you're on Windows, on Mac, or on Linux. So if you go on docs.docker.com/get-docker, you will see the installation instruction for Docker Desktop for Mac, Docker Desktop for Windows, and Docker for Linux, okay? So this is very important for you to follow the instructions. For me, for Mac, I have to download and install Docker, so you download from Docker Hub, and off you go. So when it comes to setting up Docker, there's one setting that you have to do. So if you go to my top bar, my Docker desktop is running, and I go to preferences. One thing you have to set up, and I will show you right now, is that we need to add a little bit more RAM to Docker. So I think Docker, when you install it on Mac and maybe on Windows, you come with 2 gigabytes of memory. I would suggest increasing it to 4, maybe 8 if you can. My Mac is really maxed out. I have 64 gigabytes of memory. So I usually like to set it at 16, but it's just because I have some very heavy workloads running on the Docker. For this tutorial, if you do it at 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, you are good to go. Okay. So just for me, I will set it back to where it was, which was at 16. Okay. So you apply and you restart, and then your Docker daemon will restart just to make sure that you have enough memory attached to it. Okay. If you set too much memory, obviously your system is not going to be happy. So anything between 4 and 8 gigabytes will be fine. So once Docker is installed, stop Kafka first on your command line. So this is, again, optional, but I like to show you this because we'll be using Docker a lot to start bigger Kafka clusters. So Kafka is shut down, and then I'm going to also shut down Zookeeper. So both my programs are shut down correctly. And now what I need to do is just open up this file on my computer. Okay, so I am in my Kafka Stack Docker Compose directory, and as we can see, everything looks good. So what I'm going to do is just make sure that Docker is running, so I can do docker minus version, minus version to show me the version of Docker, which is version 20 for me. And then if you docker run hello world, this is just to ensure that hello world is going to run on Docker, that Docker is working correctly. So if you cannot find the hello world latest image locally, what's going to happen is that it's going to be downloading that image for you and then running it. And then once it is run, you see all this hello from Docker, which means that Docker is running correctly. So we're good to go. Docker is functioning on my laptop. And so to get started to run Apache Kafka, we're going to run this file called zk single kafka single, which represents one zookeeper and one Kafka. This is a Docker Compose file, so you need to install Docker Compose if you don't have it as well. So make sure to type install Docker Compose. And there's again some documentation on how to do it. So you can run Compose on Mac, Linux, Windows, and Linux. And so it's saying like for desktop for Mac and Windows, Docker Compose is already installed, so this is perfect. But on Linux systems, you need to install something on top of it. So just so you know, so if you have Mac and Windows, you are good to go. Okay, so this is a YAML file, and this is something that I've created myself to help you get up and running with Apache Kafka on your computer. So you don't need to worry too much about the configuration. This is quite advanced, okay? But just so you know, in one command, we'll be able to run Kafka. And the command is docker compose minus f to specify a file. Then you need to specify the file name that we have. So it's zk single kafka single.yaml. And then just the up command. And this is going to create Zookeeper and Kafka for us. So if the images are not downloaded already on your laptop, which they shouldn't be, you're going to get a long download. And then once the long download is finished, then you're going to get all this log output, and that means that Kafka is running. So as you can see in here, we have Kafka and Zookeeper running. So Kafka 1 is running, and if I scroll up, Zookeeper 1 is running as well. So everything is working correctly. And you need to make sure not to close this interface as well, because that means that if you close it, Kafka and Zookeeper would stop. And so if you want to just check the status, you do Docker Compose, and instead of up, you do PS. And as you can see, both Kafka and Zookeeper are up and running, and we are good to go. So that's it for this way of starting Kafka and Zookeeper using Docker, which I like a lot because it is much easier, and it will be easier for us to set up a cluster later on. So that's it for this lecture. I hope you liked it, and I will see you in the next lecture.